Hey, Sushan, what is going on? So I got this AI. It's typing ahead of me sometimes with the Python code. Tabnine, I think it's called. I'm using Tabnine preview, something like that. Anyway, it's the basic version. So I got this little module here. Choosing a flag, and then it spits out the language based on the nationality chosen for the flag kind of thing. So I say, explain this. And tab 9 proceeds to spit out what this code does. Looks legit. It's very generic. It's like, let's see. It's talking about the flag, nationality, setting the flag of the flag box. Flag. I have a flag not chosen flag here. It's kind of redundant, but if you choose the flag, it does the thing. It's basically saying what it's doing. This then down here says, this function is used to disable or enable the GUI elements related to nationality based on whether a nationality has been chosen or not. That's fine. That's fine. So I got this gender one. So I click on the gender one. Come on. Explain the gender box change. So now the AI is going to tell me what this routine does. When I click on the choose gender box, and it says the selected code is part of a function that is triggered when the user selects a gender for the character. I just have male and female. Male, female. It earlier it was putting other and other stuff, and I'm like, whoa, male, female. So is this is the AI woke? Is the AI woke? Male, female. The code checks whether the user has chosen a gender or not. If the user has not chosen a gender, the function sets the gender variable to an empty string. Yes, to an empty string. And sets a flag gender not chosen to true. Yeah, sets it to true. Gender not chosen, true. If the user has chosen a gender, the function sets the gender variable to the selected gender and sets the gender not chosen flag to false. Okay, so if you choose a gender, it's male or female. The list is male or female. Two choices. Sets the what is it? It disables the button after you select your gender, it disables the button. So it's not a thing anymore. You're not flipping back and forth. You pick one and that's it. But then it adds this little paragraph here, which I didn't ask for. It says the code is written in a way that allows for easy modification and extension. For example, if the number of genders available to the user is increased, the code can be easily modified to accommodate the new gender options. I would say that tab 9 is woke. Just saying.